Hi guys, and welcome back to another IBRACORP video. Hope you guys have had a great week. It's been a busy one over here, over at IBRACORP, as we're currently trying to build a new server. And it's our first time building one with a rack, so it's been a bit of a learning adventure. I've been taking some photos along the way, so hopefully I'll be able to share that progress with you once it's done. But I'm expecting it to take quite some time because we're not trying to rush it. So we'll let you know once it's finished. I'll put a video out there about it as well. Today, we're just gonna be going through hopefully a quick one, which is setting a theme for your Unraid server. So I put up a photo on our community tab on our channel a few days ago, shouting out a developer who's made plenty of themes before, probably for apps you've already seen. And they include ones for Organizer, Flex, the Unraid UI, plenty of other things as well. And I'll just show you what that looks like in a second. But today we're gonna be showing you the login screen. I didn't actually think anybody would be that interested, but it seems that people have asked me to actually make a video on it, so I'll show you how to do it today. And what you're looking at here is an example that was sent to me by the developer for our main server, Zeus. So it was pretty cool to see in a photo sent to me that way. So then I've had a look and gone through the instructions, so we'll walk you through that today. Please enjoy. If you haven't already, please remember to like and subscribe. If you enjoy our content, we really appreciate it. Without further ado, let's get stuck into it. Okay, so we're here on the image that I've been sent. As you can see, it looks really, really cool. And it's pretty customizable as well. So we'll go to the developer's GitHub page. And here he is here, gilbN. I'm not sure if that's how you want to pronounce it, mate, but I'm just going to call it gilbN for the rest of the video. So thanks to his hard work, he's licensed out his work so people can use it. So going through his main page here, you can see there's themes here for all sorts of stuff. If you go down to the current themes in the repo, you'll see you've got Sonarr, Radarr, you know, themes for all of this, basically, he's gone and created, which is really, really cool. When it comes to Unraid, if we just open up the Unraid one, you can actually change the theme of the Unraid UI itself. But in today's example, we're just going to go through the login screen because I think that's one of the coolest things he's done. I've got the instructions here. I'll go through them. We'll go through them together, and I'll have the link in the description for you. So if you've watched our video on the top 20 plugins for Unraid, you'll know that one of them that I suggested was the CA User Scripts plugin. And the reason why I suggested it was because people in the community will often give you a script if they're trying to help you with something, and it makes it easy for you to load into your server. The instructions today, they ask us to have the plugin, and he's gonna provide us with a bash script. So if you don't have the plugin, just go over to the App Store. So type in User Scripts, ring up a whole bunch of stuff, but the one we want is this one here by Squid. So big thanks to Squid for his work there. Once you've installed it, you pretty much just click that, guys. Click to install. It'll install it. You can then go to the settings for it. So click add new script and we'll give it a name. So we'll call it Unraid login screen. Click OK. And you can see it's here now. So there's nothing in it yet. That's what we need to do now. So if we just click on the left here and go to edit script, we've now got an available space to put our script into. So following his documentation still, it asks us to paste the contents of the bash script, custom underscore login. So I've got that script here. So I'm gonna go ahead and copy that in. Bang, copied in, pretty straightforward. Let's go back to the instructions. So then it says, so below the shebang are the variables we need to change for the different themes. So he's highlighted this section here, the type, retro, etc. So I'm going to move this back over. And if we just look through the script, it's right at the top. If I go back to the documentation here real quick, I'll just go back. This is the main link. So I'll put that in there. Now, what you're doing is you're having a look at which one you like, whether it's the retro, alien, or the Fallout themes. And they all look pretty cool. I like the retro one, so I've clicked on the retro terminal. So then he's provided instructions for that specific theme. So really, we don't really need to change too much here besides probably the theme colors. So I'll just move this over. So you can see theme equals green.css. So we're going to change that to red. I just like the idea of the red one. Following his documentation still, set the values to what you like and click save changes. So we filled it all in. We're happy with that. We're going to go ahead and click save changes. That's now saved. So the next step, change the startup option. So that way we can have it start up at every boot. So under the scheduling option here, we'll say at startup of array, perfect. Go ahead and click apply and the schedule's now been applied. So the actual script hasn't been run yet. So we're just gonna go ahead and run that and done. So hopefully if we log out now, there's our new theme. How about that? Looks pretty cool. It's a little bit animated here as well. pretty rad. If you're happy with it looking exactly like that, then you don't really have to change anything. But if you want to have a custom logo or change the ASCII setup here, then what you'll need to do is fork the GitHub repo so that you can customize it the way you want. So to do that, we'll go back onto GitHub here. Okay, so we're signed in on GitHub. We're signed into our account and we want to now fork this so that we can have our own copy of it. So that's fine. We'll go ahead and click fork up in the top right corner and we're pretty much done. So now it's under my GitHub and I've forked his work so that we can then customize the things that we want. Okay, so now we've forked it, we can see that it's underneath the IBRACORP name now. So to customize the Unraid login screen, we'll go into CSS folder, go to add-ons, Unraid login page, and here we've got our themes. So we went with the retro, so we'll go to retro. Then underneath the retro, we've got your CSS themes here for the different colors. So we went with red, so let's go to red. Now in this field, you'll see the logo line here. So if you want to add your own logo, all I did was go to Imgur, uploaded our logo, and then I've put the URL here. Then I've opened an incognito page just to make sure the cache has been refreshed. And as you can see, it pulled the logo through. Make sure you run the script, of course, first, guys. So go back to your scripts and just make sure you run the script. Once you've run the script, then you can know for sure that it's actually pulled down the latest information. That also means it's pulling down from our repo. So how's it doing that? If we go to edit, for the domain, you can see I've just put github.com/IBRACORP. So that part's pretty much done. So it's pulled our logo down, which is awesome. And now we basically just want to change the ASCII code. So we'll do that. We'll minimize this and we'll go back into here and just go back to Retro Terminal and under JS, Custom Text Header. You can see we put this in here, but it doesn't seem like it's wanted to pull it through. So I'm not sure why. It's just not updating this top part here. So there might be something I've done wrong, guys. If I have, please let me know. But as you can see, it's a pretty damn cool theme. He's got other themes as well for the actual Unraid UI, as well as a bunch of other apps. So make sure you check out his GitHub page, gilbN on GitHub. So GitHub/gilbN. And you can check out all of his work there. So big thanks to him for his hard work here. I really appreciate it. If you guys liked it, give us a big thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. It really helps the channel out. And if you have any suggestions for the next video, drop them in the comments down below. Thank you very much. And we'll see you in the next IBRACORP video.